I'm in the world, my senses are flooded with sights and sounds and smells, and it seems obvious that reality is just out there. There's a person, there's a cab. All I have to do is show up, and my senses let me experience it all.
But there's a twist to this story.
Our perception of reality has less to do with what's happening out there and more to do with what's happening in here.
To understand what's going on, we first need to know how information from the world around us gets into the brain. It feels as if sights and sounds just stream in through our eyes and our ears. But imagine if you could climb inside a human skull.
When you step into the skull, you'll find there's no way for light or sound or smells to get directly in here.
This is a sealed chamber. So the brain sits in darkness and in silence. It's in total isolation.
Your brain's never seen the outside world, but somehow you experience it. Now, this might seem straightforward because we have portals to the outside world, like your eyes and ears, but these aren't just piping in sights and sounds. Instead, photons of light or air compression waves, these are getting converted into the common currency of the brain, electrochemical signals.
These signals travel through dense networks of brain cells called neurons. There are 100 billion neurons in the human brain. And in every second of your life, each one of these is sending tens or hundreds of electrical pulses to thousands of other neurons.
And somehow, all of this activity produces your sense of reality. So whether it's the bark of a dog or the smell of coffee or a view of a beautiful sunset, it's all made of the same stuff in here.
And this is the stuff of reality.